Hi, this is Emily from MinuteEarth. For the red squirrels of Canada's Yukon Territory, 2010 was an extra busy year. Every fall, the squirrels gather seed cones from white spruce trees and hoard them underground for later. And most years, each tree produces around 100 cones. But in 2010, all the white spruces in the region cranked their cone making way up, producing almost 3,000 cones each. This wasn't a freak event. It's a phenomenon called masting, in which all the plants of a particular species in an area go totally nuts in a big baby-making bonanza. Which is weird. How can trees coordinate with each other over hundreds of miles?
And why do they go to the effort?
Well, they can't talk over long distances, so we think they're all responding to the same regional weather cues, like rainfall and warm springtime temperatures. And that weather might simply be particularly good for baby making. But it's also possible that the trees are using the weather as a cue to do something a lot more strategic. For species that rely on the wind to carry male pollen from one tree to the female flowers of another, the best way for any one tree to make lots of babies is for all the trees to make lots of pollen and lots of flowers. But because going big every year takes a ton of energy, some types of trees may have evolved to save up their reproductive energy for occasional tree sex extravaganzas. Some types of trees also seem to use masting as a way to protect their seeds from seed predators. For example, squirrels like to eat acorns, which is a problem for oak trees because acorns that get eaten don't become trees. And if a population of oak trees produces the same number of acorns every year, the local population of squirrels will likely grow until it can eat just that number of acorns. But if the oak trees keep acorn production low most years, the squirrel population will also stay low. And then, during so-called mast years, those few squirrels can stuff themselves silly without putting a dent in the acorn supply, leaving plenty behind to sprout and grow. So for some trees, masting could be a way to extend the life of their species without becoming feces.